Hello, just give it a few more minutes, wait for a few, if anyone else is joining. Just give it another minute or so, and then we'll start. Okay, well, I'm going to start. If anyone else joins, Robin, if you let them in. But yeah, thanks for joining us on our webinar today. We're going to be talking about job templates, how to create them, why you want to create them, and how to use them effectively. So in the next 20 minutes or so, we'll show you how to set up your job templates. We'll provide some of the reasons our customers choose for setting up different types of templates, and we'll also show you a few examples that some of our customers use and are available within the template builder. Just a bit of housekeeping to ensure this webinar runs smoothly. Please, can you? I think you're on mute at the moment, but yeah, if you just keep on mute until the end when we get to the questions section. I am working from home, so if my broadband does cut out, I'll try and reconnect. So please just bear with me. And if you do want the slides at the end of the webinar, then let us know. I'm happy to share them at the end of the webinar. This is the last in our series of webinars for this year. We started the year off talking about the VAT reverse charge. Then we went on to discuss things you might not know about Okappy. We talked about getting your invoices paid on time with Paul Late from Next Level Business. We were joined by Alexander Lowe of Lately.ai to talk about networking on LinkedIn and Okappy. And more recently, we talked about the different reports you can use to spot trends and proactively market and grow your business. And for our newer customers and prospects, Joe talked about things to consider when implementing workforce management last month. So we're going to take a break in December, but we'll be back early next year with some new webinars. We'll also be trialing a new format, a shorter webinar, where we'll just talk about a specific smaller feature within Okappy. So watch this space for more details on that. You can view all the previous webinars from our events page and also see what's coming up. So check out okappy.com events. And don't forget to follow us on Eventbrite, where we give early bird tickets, offers, and to ensure you don't miss out, some of our events have been sold out. So make sure you follow us on there as well. As I said, if you do want the slides or videos from any of the previous webinars, they're all available on okappy.com events or drop us a line. So firstly, for those of you who don't know who Okappy is, Okappy is a business-to-business connected workforce management platform, which applies social and market networking technology to a real business need. The need to communicate and collaborate when working with employees at different locations, and obviously now more so than ever. When working with different subcontractors and when working with different clients. Okappy helps the most forward-looking and dynamic companies increase transparency, reduce duplication, costs and errors, and increase efficiency, making a significant contribution to bottom line profits. With Okappy, you can connect to your employees, customers, and subcontractors. You can send and receive jobs, and you can see the status of those jobs as they're updated by your engineer or subcontractor out in the field. You can also raise invoices from your jobs. You can send messages from the desktop to the mobile apps. And we've got the connections, the customer database in there as well. Now, Okappy is used by a wide cross-section of businesses who often have different requirements in terms of the information they need. So with Okappy, you can create different types of jobs to fit the different types of works you do. And that's what we're going to be covering today. So we're going to cover why different companies may want different templates. Also, a lot of our companies often have more than one string to their bow. So we'll be exploring why you might want different types of templates, even within your own business. We'll then introduce the template builder. And finally, I'm going to show you a few examples of some of the types of templates that you can build. So why set up different types of jobs? Why set up different templates? Often it's because companies do different types of work. So you might have a plumbing or electrical division, and the requirements may vary between job. You might also do the same job for different types of customers. For example, if you do work for corporate clients, you may want to have a risk assessment filled out when your engineer first opens the job. Whereas if they're doing work for domestic customers, then that might not be as important. In that case, you might want a customer feedback form to be completed once the job is done. And different corporate clients may have specific requirements or may even want a job sheet in their own format. A lot of our customers, particularly in the drainage space, white label their services to larger companies, and they often ask for their job sheets to have not just specific fields and check sheets, but also to use their customers' branding. And this is also possible within Okappy. We're also seeing a lot of companies now setting up jobs for their own internal purposes. Particularly last year, we saw a lot of companies create furlough job templates with the aim to communicate to the team, get their employees sign off, and easily keep track of what is going on in the business. So we're seeing companies adding holiday forms, sickness forms, and much more. And the potential is really limitless. So if you do have ideas for your own templates, then let us know. We're always kind of keen to hear of different ways that people and different companies are using Okappy. So we talked about the why of creating different templates. Now we're going to get into the how, and we're going to go through the template builder. So I'll show you how to create a template. I'll show you the template builder layout, the key parts of the templates, the header and footer, the job details, and the check sheets. And then I'll show you the advanced options. I'm just going to bring up my demo account. So to create a job template, close some screens. Yeah, so to create a job template, click job options, and then job sheet templates. It is an option, so if you don't see that button there, drop us a line, let us know, and we can get that enabled for you on your account. But if you click job sheet templates, you see all your list of templates. We have some standard ones and any ones that you've created. From here, you can copy the template, you can view or edit your template, or you can delete it if it's not needed any longer. To create a new template, click the new template button, and then you've got a few different options. You can create a new template from scratch, you can copy one of your existing templates, or you can use one of our library of templates. Or if you don't have the time or the inclination, or you want to use our experience to kind of really tweak the template, we can do that for you as well. Purchase configuration, for a small charge, we can create those templates for you. If you want to create a template, I'll show you how to do it from here. This basically is the template builder. You've got the template name. It's always worth putting that in at the start, just so that you don't forget to go through all the work and then you forget to add the name. You've got, you can preview the template, so you can see what it looks like on the desktop and what it looks like on the mobile. That uses default text. What we always say, actually, if you create the template, if you add a job and then go through the process of updating the job, that's often the kind of the best way to really see how the template will work, what it will look like. And you can certainly kind of edit the template once it's done. So you do have these two options here, but as I say, kind of it's worth adding the job and seeing what it looks like in real life. We've got a template wizard here. So if you do forget what we've gone through in this webinar, click that button and that'll take you through all the different aspects of the template builder. But basically a template is split up into kind of three key sections. You've got the header and the footer. You've got the job details section, and that's the bit that's typically filled out either within the office or by your customers. So job details, site address, etc. And then you have the three check sheets, and you can have a check sheet at various stages of the job. So you can have an initial check sheet, and often, as I say, that's like a risk assessment. So fields around kind of like escape of water, exposed wiring, for example. If you have fields in the the pre-job check sheet, then that will show as soon as your engineer or technician goes into a job, before they can click on site, they have to update that risk assessment. If you leave this blank, then no risk assessment or no initial check sheet will be shown. The word done check sheet, now that is on all job sheets, that is there by default. If you don't add any information, it will default to the standard fields, which I think are materials, materials costs, labor and labor cost. And then you've also got a check sheet at the end, again, optional. If you leave it blank, then nothing will show. If you've got fields in here, and as I say, typically a kind of customer feedback form, we see those a lot. Engineer arrived on time, they were courteous, professional. Can we use this? Can we use your information for marketing purposes? Those type of fields. If you have those fields set, your end of job check sheet set, then that shows once the job's been completed, that shows as the final stage in that job. But I'll add a check sheet on in a bit. First, I'll just start with the header and footer and the job details. So to add a header, just click in edit header, click add field, then you can add a name for your template. You can have large text, small text. You can also add images. So that could be your company logo. You can also create really kind of distinctive designs with the templates. A lot of customers will make the kind of the logo or the banner, the image that goes at the top, they'll put lots of details in there, lots of branding in there. And you can kind of use that to really tweak the design of your template. I'll just leave that for now with the sample text. Footer, same, add text, add images. So again, address details, VAT number, payment terms, etc. You can put in there. So that's the header and the footer. Then we've got the main job details part. And as I say, this is the bit that's typically filled out in the office. So the details of the job, so the customer details, the job requirements, details of the job, where keys are, etc. So you can create a group. So let's just call that contact details. And you can have that show or not, as the case may be. And then within a group, you can start adding your fields. So if we add, let's put a first field name, second field, let's add an address. Let's call that landlord address. And then say site address. Just to note, when you're adding the fields, you've got a drop down of various fields you can check. The details in brackets, that's how it maps to the columns on your job dashboard. So for example, if you had address one, address two set, if you've got it in the job sheet, then any information entered into those fields will also be shown on the job dashboard. Likewise, the mobile, if you have mobile field, telephone field, or any like columns 1 to 5, entering information in the job sheet will mirror with what's shown on the dashboard, depending on what columns you've got shown. I'm just going to add one more job description. Also, you can make the fields mandatory and you can make them editable. What that means is that if it's editable, then your engineers can also update or edit those fields when they're out on site on their mobile as well. So I'll leave those fields, just got a couple of fields on, and then I'll start adding a check sheet. Again, very similar, add your group. You can have a group name with details. You can show it or not. And then you can start adding fields. With the check sheet, because it's not tied to the columns on the dashboard, you've got a bit more flexibility in terms of the types of fields you can have. So you can have small text field, medium text, large text. So let's have a large text field. Work done. You can have checkboxes, ratings fields. So yeah, professional. Let's put that scale 1 to 5. And you can have checkboxes, images taken, and let's say drop down as well. And well, I'll just leave that for now. You can also have a lot more fields. So whereas the job dashboard, you're limited to like the columns that are on the dashboard. With the check sheet, you can have basically as many fields as you want. Although the caveat, obviously, particularly with mobile devices, the network can be slow, it can be patchy. Obviously, the bigger the template is, the more information the mobile is having to pull down. Also in terms of usability as well, if your guys are having to kind of scroll and scroll and scroll to get the information they want, the harder you make it, then that's when you start to hear the excuses, oh, the battery's run out, I've dropped my phone, I've not brought my phone, etc. So in our experience, what we say is to try and streamline the check sheet as much as possible, just keep it to like the key details. We recommend kind of 20, 30 fields at most. We do have customers that have hundreds upwards of fields. Often we see as well, when customers first sign up with Okappy, they create these big, long templates with lots and lots of fields. But then as they use it, they realize actually only 20%, 30% of it is used. So it's always worth trying to kind of streamline it down as much as possible. But that's the work done check sheet added. I won't add the other two for now. The final bit of the template builder is the options. So here you can have various options. So signature is mandatory. So if that's checked, that means the engineer can't complete the job until the signature has been taken. You can have a default job duration. So that's particularly useful if you're using the calendar screen. You could have some jobs that are, for example, an hour, whereas other jobs automatically are added on for 3 hours. And then on the jobs dashboard, you've got the columns where it goes from a red dot to a flashing dot if it's overdue to a tick. This is where you can define, for example, if the job's not being viewed within an hour, it'll start to flash. And you can obviously make that bigger, 90 minutes, 30 minutes, you can change that, you've got the control here. And that's on a template by template basis. Likewise with the job duration, you can also set the default appointment date. So if you leave it as zero, if you add a job without changing the appointment time, it will add it on for the current time. But you can set that if all your jobs are at least a week in advance, you set that to 5 days, 6 days, etc. Then if you don't set the appointment date, it will automatically add the job on in the future for you. Again, for different customers or different types of jobs, sometimes you might want to show the on-site time, the completed time. Other jobs, you might include travel times that you might not want to show those. So again, you can turn that on and off by template from the job options. Show link back to job sheet in the related invoice. So if you raise an invoice from a job, if you've got that checked, if you send the invoice to the customer, there's a link on that invoice. The customer can then go back easily and see the job. So that saves you sending out a job sheet and an invoice. It means you don't necessarily have to copy all the information from the job sheet onto the invoice because they can just link back to it. If you do have a pre-job check sheet or a check sheet at the end, then you can tick these and that will show on the final job sheet that you send to your customer. Obviously, the work done is always on the template. And then finally, you can define, if you use the text messages, you can send a text message when the job gets added to your customer, and also one on the day of the appointment. Here, you can change the text that's sent out, so you can put whatever you need in there. So click Update Job Options to save those details. And then you've also got a Raise Invoice options as well. So this is when you're raising an invoice from a job, you can control what information gets pulled across automatically. So anything that's ticked, if you've got work done ticked, it'll pull the work done that your engineer technicians added onto the job sheets. If you've got a customer reference, that'll pull through, any addresses that'll pull through, and it pulls through in this order. So that's basically the job template. I'm gonna save that now. So always remember to save the templates. And then if we go back to the exit builder, and there we go, we've got the sample template that I've just created. So now if I go back into the job screen, I click new job, and there you go, it's in my jobs dropdown. So if I click that, choose a customer, initial job. So you see here, it's picked up automatically as today's date because I didn't change the future date of the job. I click use customer details. choose an address and example of job. Add that job, and that job's got added. And if I go into the job on the mobile, obviously it'll take you through each step. So on site, work done and completed. You can also update it from the web as well. So if I go straight to the work done sheet, and you can see the fields that I added. So lots of work, very professional, no images taken, example one. So update that, complete that job off, update that job. And then here's the finished product. So you'd have all the branding at the top. So if you had your logo, any images, you've got all the job details and then the information that the technician engineers filled out on their mobile device. And that's basically the template builder. We have step-by-step instructions on help and support. There's a video on there as well. I'll show you that at the end of the webinar. But we try and kind of keep it simple, easy to use, and you can add as many templates as you want, depending on what type of account you've got. So that was how to create a template. Now I'm just gonna show you a quick run through of some of the examples that our customers, we've seen our customers set up. A lot of these are available in our standard templates list, so you can copy them, you can create your own template from them. I won't go into them in too much detail, but hopefully they'll just inspire you as some of the different things you can do with your templates. If you do want to go into any detail about any specific one, we can come back to it at the end. Just let me know. So this is an example of a wage transfer note. This is one that our customer uses. Obviously, I've blurred out their information. But you can see they've got their logo at the top, they've got contact details, a title at the top of the template. Then within the main body of the template is the wage transfer note. It follows kind of specific requirements. So they've actually got it set up as section B. It's the bit that they fill out in the office, the current location of the waste. And then section A onwards is the bit the driver fills out once he's delivered to the drop-off point. So a description of the waste, EWC codes, amount of waste, etc. This is an example of a gas check. Again, similar, you've got the address at the top, tenant address, landlord address, for example. And then in the work done check sheets, you've got various groups of different appliances. These could be drop down, so you could select from manufacturer, again, type could be drop downs. And then you've got checkboxes owned by landlord, inspected, and then text fields as well, location, text field, or drop down. Electrical check, again, you've got logo at the top and company information. And then very similar, you've got all the contact details, site address, work requested in the main body of the job. And then in the work done check sheet, you've got a text field there, probably a smaller text field, and then various checkboxes, certificates required, certificate uploaded, etc. Inventory, again, similar, logo at the top, job details here. They've got a few more fields here, but similar kind of thing, address, contact details, job details. And then in the work done section, you've got a yes, no field, a couple of yes, no fields, and a couple of text fields. Quotes are a bit more interesting, as there's a couple of different ways that you can set up a quote on Okappy. The usual way is to create a quote from the invoicing section. And in that way, the quote can pull through the inventory items from either Xero or QuickBooks or from your settings. It'll pull through the prices and it'll automatically work out the quote net amount. The other way we can set up a quote, which is more relevant to this webinar today, is you can actually create, or some customers create, a job template for quotes. And that gives them a bit more flexibility in terms of the information that can be captured. It can be assigned to a particular customer. It also means the quote can be added or updated by the engineers, your engineers on their mobile devices. But again, very similar thing. You've got a logo at the top, job details or quote details in the main section, and then further details in one of the check sheets. Now turning to some internal uses, we have companies setting up holiday forms, which either the office or the engineers can fill out. The beauty of a holiday form is that it's immediately visible on the calendar, so you can see at a glance who is off, when they're off, etc. One of the things with the calendar, you can also change the color of different job templates, and that's another reason why you might want to have multiple different templates. So for example, if you have the holiday form as green and standard jobs as orange, then it's really easy to see at a glance when people are off, when they're in, when they're off, etc. And the final example I'm going to show you is a timesheet. Again, like a quote, there are various ways that you can capture employee hours in Okappy. You can automatically capture the start and end time using the Okappy app, so when they log in and when they log out at the end of the day, or using one of our GPS trackers, so the first time the vehicle switched on in the morning to the last time it switched off. That's one way. You can also create a standalone check sheet, which the engineers can then add a check sheet and add their hours. So those fields could be like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, hours worked, overtime, checkbox, etc. Or you can create a job template. So similar to the other templates we've shown, you can actually set up a template as a timesheet. And then again, yeah, the job details or the timesheet details. And then you could have a check sheet within that. Again, similar Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and the hours worked. The benefit of setting a timesheet up as a job template is, again, that can be assigned to a customer. So it makes it easier to link kind of hours to specific customers if that's what you're looking to kind of report on. Cool. So coming up to half an hour. So just a quick recap. We talked about why you might want to set up different templates because of the different types of work you do, to fit in with specific requirements, or just to kind of make it easier to see what's going on in your business. We explored the template builder, so the key sections, we talked about the header and footer, the job details section, the check sheets, and then the advanced options. And then finally, I showed you a few examples that we've seen some of our customers use. And as I say, the sky's the limit in terms of what templates you can build. And yeah, if you do have any ideas or examples, then please don't hesitate to share them with us. Always interested to hear how people use Okappy. As always, there's lots of help and support available on Okappy, okappy.com support, and a couple of articles here, in particular, creating the job template that'll take you through step by step how to create a template. There's also a video on there as well, which actually gives a bit more detail about how to create the template. So that's always worth looking at. So yeah, thanks once again for attending our webinar. I hope you found it useful. Stay tuned for our webinars next year. And if there are any questions, happy to take them now. Yeah, if you just wanna stick them in the chat, we've just got a couple of minutes. If I don't get time to get through them all, we'll get back to you afterwards. Or even if you think of anything after the webinar, then yeah, please don't hesitate to drop us a line. Just got a question here. How many templates can we have? Well, if you've got a trial account or if you're a connection, then you can have up to 5 templates. If you've got a standard account, then you can have as many templates as you want. What happens if I add a job with a template and then change the templates? Well, that's a good question. If the template changes, if the questions and answers are different, then if you've added a job with a previous version of the template and those questions are not on the new version of the template, then the answers, it won't be displayed on the job. But the versions are stored within Okappy, and jobs done with previous versions of the template keep that original version of the template. So you can change them, you can update them to the newer version, but if it does have different fields, if it does have questions and answers, then yeah, potentially that information won't show. Although obviously if you change it back again to the old version, the information is still stored in Okappy, it will be available then. think we've just got time for one more question. How many fields can we have on the job templates? So yeah, in the main body of the template, I think there's about 25 fields, which kind of tie into the columns on the job dashboard. Within the check sheet section, you can have a lot more. You can have as many as you want. Although, as I mentioned, given the constraints of mobile devices, screen size and network and usability, we always suggest trying to limit it. We'd recommend about kind of 20, 30 or so. But you've got a lot more flexibility in terms of the check sheets, what fields you have and how many fields that you have. Cool. There's a couple more. We've just come up to 30 minutes, so I'm going to close it down now. I'll get back to the questions that I didn't manage to answer. I'll get back to you afterwards. But yeah, thanks for attending. I hope you found it useful, and we look forward to seeing you in the new year for our next webinars. Thank you. Thanks a lot.